संसार का हर पूरा
शीर मोह और जोन और
रहत शम्स
ले आओ आओ हां
ऐसे आई अच्छे
सूरज के नीचे
सूरज तले
आओ
Every year in America, one-fifth of all new students join a powerful and secret society, which is known as the Greek system.
Is it starting soon?
Yeah.
The men are enticed into fraternity houses. And in stark contrast, the women are wooed into sorority houses. Joining a fraternity or sorority is regarded as being given a lifelong advantage, which could see many of these people as America's future leaders.
There's a high chance that you're getting a snapshot of the men and women that just went through this process, that joined membership, are going to be the future leadership of this country in 5 or 10 years.
But this is no ordinary year here in America. And at this precise time, the best-known Greek member in the United States is having his leadership skills closely scrutinized. And at the same time, here at the University of Iowa, recruitment into the Greek system is about to begin. Students arrive 1 week before autumn term starts in an attempt to join. One such sorority hopeful is 19-year-old art student Amy Jones. Amy is just one of 750,000 American students who will soon start a week-long recruitment marathon that could change her life forever. This unique recruitment process is called Rush.
Two people are gonna have to share it. Two bucks are gonna have to share it. And these are like, I don't know what these are. They kind of look like fire blankets. I don't even know why I'm touching them. They're probably like pee protectors. Lord knows what these mattresses have been through.
Before arriving in Iowa and launching her sorority bid, Amy had secured letters of recommendation and references from family, friends, and other Greek members in an effort to support her application. And if successful, her parents would be thrilled to see her follow in the family tradition.
And my mom was like, you know, you will rush because people went through all that hard work for me. Which is true. I mean, they went through a lot of stuff. And so I was like, I'm doing it because my mother's making me. But I changed like that anyway. Girls are allowed to change their mind a lot. So I changed my mind real quick. And I really want to do it. And I had to call the boyfriend today because it's hard. Because it's going to take up a lot of my time. And I want to go back and visit him a lot. But if it was going to be a lot of hard. So I told him, you know, I'm going to do it. So that's another thing is the boys. You got to make sure you got time for both. So we'll see.
All over the campus, sorority and fraternity houses proudly display their names in Greek alphabet. Kappa Sigma, Pi Beta Phi, Kappa Alpha Theta, just some of the 13 sororities and 8 fraternity houses on Iowa University campus. Amy will soon start a week-long recruitment marathon, rushing from one sorority house to another, including one of the most popular houses, Alpha Chi Omega.
Well, I'm Suzanne, and I am the chapter president of the Alpha Chi Omega chapter at the University of Iowa. This is where I live, along with 48 other girls. We live here throughout the entire year, and other girls can choose to come in and out of the house if a spot opens up. And this is the inside of our house. This is the main floor. This is where most anyone can be at most any time during the day. If you go upstairs, there's no men allowed on any of those floors, and the whole structure is alcohol-free. There's no alcohol on any of the premises. If you go through the doors over there, there's a lounge where we watch TV and that sort of thing. If you go down the steps, There's more of a dining room, and that's where we eat all of our meals together. And then if you go over into this room, this is the formal living room, but a lot of girls use this to study. It's a little bit quieter. And then actually you're going to catch kind of a unique glance. We're practicing right now, and for one of our parties, the preference party.
These rituals are rarely performed in the presence of outsiders. And in the actual ceremony, they use real candles.
It's glowing. That's how it is with the flocket. Once you've experienced it, you spread your love to everyone. You want to pass it on.
Everyone who does not use a candle like this throughout the whole thing is going to be in trouble.
The University of Iowa and its fraternity and sorority system attracts students from all over America.
Iowa is the heartland of America. It's a political barometer in our country, so we think we're kind of important, and I'd live no other place.
Trying to keep the students out of trouble is Director of Student Affairs at Iowa University, Mary Peterson. She is on her way to oversee this year's recruitment.
Well, a long time ago, when this country first started, colleges here were just men. That's the only people allowed in the colleges. There was one building, and your professor was your professor, and the person oversaw you where you lived. And they were pretty staunch about their ideas. You only had to believe and think what they thought. And so the young men thought, that's not good. We want the opportunity to sit and talk about ideologies and where this country is going, whatever. So they went to a pub, if you will, and they had a tankard of ale. And they said, we're going to start this secret society, and we want it to be secret because we don't want the professors to find out because they may stop us from doing it. So that's where the secret came from way back when. Men's groups started, and when women came to college, they said, if the men can do that, we can do that. So that's how sororities started. That's how it's all evolved.
For 200 years, the Greek system has permeated every facet of American leadership and is considered to be the power behind the superpower. Members include 85% of all Supreme Court judges, 86% of corporate company heads, and all but two of American presidents, including President William Jefferson Clinton, who joined the Greek fraternity of Alpha Phi Omega in 1960 at the University of Georgetown.
According to U.S. News and World Report, since Monica, Starr has added 10 new lawyers to his legal team.
During this rush, the television networks have been buzzing with speculation that after months of denial, this could be the week the president could come clean about his relationship with Monica Lewinsky.
The Greek system, just because the way society is going, their image of us is very poor right now. 30 years ago, it was, you know, they were the best women and men on campus, and now that's not. It's not to say that they aren't, it's just that people don't believe that. But that's still where the leaders and it's still where the leaders are coming from.
For the present and future leaders, the week of rush and the day of reckoning coincides. Meanwhile, at the university-owned hotel in the center of the campus, Mary Peterson has established Rush headquarters.
Oh, you'll see a lot of young women that are be a little bit nervous at the right place at the right time. You'll see lots of bodies. I mean, being logistically getting through a process to see all these, but there's a lot of logistics. That's why this computer room was like it is. It's all computerized to keep track of all these people.
It's highly complex.
Yeah, because you've got 600 people trying to see 13 different places in a short amount of time.
Mary Peterson has enlisted the help of over 70 volunteers, all based at the hotel for the duration of Rush, including senior committee member Tiffany Grimes.
Okay, so I just came out of the Rush headquarters office where we answer all the phones.
For Tiffany, this is the last year she'll be involved in Rush.
Everything is, this entire floor has to do with Rush. That's all it's about. So we have rooms. We have four to a room. We've got two double beds. And you have to share a bed with somebody. And it's really gross.
Go Green! Go Green!
The Greek alphabet is incorporated into a catchy tune that is the first of many serenades for the 650 prospective new members.
For our country, I don't know what I think. I mean, I don't know if he should be impeached or what. I know there'll be talk of it. There's already been talk of it if he does. If he doesn't admit to it, I think it's going to be another OJ thing. Like, everybody knows he's guilty, but he got off or something.
Meanwhile, the Greek recruitment process of Rush must go on. And sororities and fraternities are opening their doors for the first of four distinct recruitment days. All prospective new members are split into small groups and will visit each of the 13 sorority houses in turn.
Good morning and welcome to Alpha Chi Omega. Won't you please come in?
This first distinct stage of recruitment is called Hi, Nice to Meet You Day.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Come on in. Yep.
Everybody is on their best behavior.
Okay.
Would you like any water?
Sure, thank you, since you're holding it. All right.
So you go by Jonesy, okay?
Yes, Amy Jones. So Jonesy is just simpler because there's a lot of Amy's on our floor and everything like that.
The conversations that you have here at Alpha Chi are not going to be anything that is fake. It all comes from our hearts, and that's not because we're not the type of people to do that. That sort of thing, that's one of the things we pride ourselves on, is that sort of realness that we give to all the girls.
The process adheres to extremely strict rules and regulations, which include all house members must walk around with their hands behind their back. Only water is allowed as refreshment. All napkins must be returned after use. All house members must kneel in the presence of a prospective member. And the conversation is not allowed to discuss the three B's, boys, banks, and booze. With the topics of conversation severely restricted, Amy does her best to impress.
I wanted to take Swahili, but I couldn't because I didn't have room. That'd be so cool. How many people do that could just be like, dude, I speak Swahili?
Good morning and welcome to the 1998 fall recruitment at the University of Iowa. I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank all of you for coming and your enthusiasm and participation in Alpha Chi Omega. Thank you.
The rules have to be obeyed without exception, and any tiny infringement is documented and reported.
This year, there was a chapter who had strawberry in the water or the drink or something. And so we got a call into Rush headquarters. This chapter has strawberries, and strawberries are considered food, and so they're serving food, and that should be a Rush infraction. And I don't think they really ended up getting penalized for it, but it's like you had to think about it. Okay, I guess strawberry is food, and then the chapter had to be called. You know, you shouldn't really be putting strawberries in the water, and then you start to think.
What kind of penalty would be imposed on them for feeding somebody a strawberry?
For a strawberry? That's a question you'd have to ask the risk management person. They're the ones who decide the penalties.
Across town, at one of the eight fraternity houses, Pi Kappa Alpha, or Pike House, the men have their own unique approach to recruitment. Strawberry consumption and other forbidden fruits are positively encouraged.
First off, I'd like to congratulate you on three choices that you've already made. One, to come here to the University of Iowa.
Yeah!
Two, going through men's formal rush.
Yeah!
Most importantly, walking up that fucking hill.
Yeah!
They sit like vultures over there. They have like a ledge, and they just sit swinging their feet, looking at all the girls go by. Like, look at all the fresh meat, all the little Rush girls coming by, and just.
I don't know, you're just kind of walking, you're like, it's like you're in a prison. It's like they haven't seen girls in like years, and you're walking by. I mean, you can have eight eyes, and they'd still be like, yeah, you know, woohoo, come up and party with us. It's just like testosterone major everything. It's totally different than with the girls. They're asking you what you're going to major in, and the guys are like, you know, so, you gotten any lately? I mean, I don't know what they talk about. It's just insane.
How do you feel about it?
I think there's some real healthiness in men being just men together and women just being women. I think there's a real learning process in that.
But the differences are extraordinary.
Well, I don't know if there's extraordinary. I just think it's a different style, because the men are nervous too. They show their nervousness in a different way. What do? Scream, holler, whoa, 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 whoa. If that's not nervousness, if you watch a pro team, what do they do when screaming, yelling, hype? That's a nervousness. That's getting it out. It looks like they're getting geared up and tough. Hell, that's nervous. They're just not going to admit it.
All right, guys. I'm here to talk about the most important thing. Whatever they say, it's not true. This is what counts, guys. Social. Social, you know? We party here. We drink a lot of beer. Awesome. We do beer bongs. We party. We get drunk. Every fraternity does that. Great. Fun. You know, they're going to tell you they drink more beer. Awesome. Drink more beer, dude. That's great. You know, but here, guys, here we specialize in something else. Specialize in pull a pussy, guys. That's what we do here. That's our gig, right, guys? And I know all the other fraternities, they tell you, hey, you know, we bag all the brides, we pull puss. You know what that is? It's this, guys. You know, hold on.
Nick, the social secretary, has collected used underwear from every sorority.
They're good. I like them. They're fun, guys. DG's, hell of a fun. Yeah, those guys are good. Good, good. High five, been there. Who hasn't? And guys, my personal favorite, my absolute personal favorite, the fucking Gamma Fives! Let's go, come on. All right, guys.
If we could get men to be a little bit more organized and women not to be so organized, we'd probably all be a lot happier, and it's the same thing, a phenomenon. I mean, some people can say more anal, less anal, but I just think the men are still meeting people, trying to let them share about themselves and what they have to offer as a person, but they don't have as much decoration or as organized internally to deal with it, not at all.
Well, thank you. Thanks. Bye, ladies. Hey, thank you.
Of the ones they want to revisit, and at the same time, the sororities reject the girls they don't want back. This is called the first cut.
This is the list of, in alphabetical order, of all the women they invited back. They just want to make sure they've got everybody on there that they invited yes to. It's every single woman. That's all. It's double checking that we've got it all there. That's all they're going to do.
Amy and her fellow Rushies wait nervously for the results. However, for the women, the first cut is based less on beauty and more on brains. And the most successful of the Rushies in demand can be invited back to a maximum of 9 houses.
Listen, let me get you the scope. Okay, ladies, this is imperative. I need your attention.
The results are hand-delivered by Katie, the group's personal counselor. Katie, a sorority member, is forbidden from revealing which house she belongs to.
Out. We talked about confidentiality and the importance of not talking about this, not looking at your neighbors. I know you want to. Please don't do it. It's utterly important. So what I'm going to do is, Andrew, I want you to start at the end of the hall. I want you to sit, face, zigzag across the hall. Okay, yes, I'm sorry. Thank you for giving me a room. Okay, no, I want you guys to sit zigzag across the hall. I will come up and down the hall with your invites. I'm so proud of all of you guys. This is so exciting for you. Julie, yes.
The first thing I did was to try and remember, you see all the names, but you don't remember like which one it was, so I had to go through and look at the houses, because I remember by the houses and not by the names, because all the names end up running together, so I looked at it by that, and then some of them I got, some of them I didn't, and I'm happy with what happened. You know, you're not going to get your favorite every time, you're not going to get, you know, the worst one, so it's good to, I'm good, I'm glad.
You got a few you can go back to.
I do, I have a handful, and I mean, it's always nice that I was expecting to get two, so.
So you tell us how many you got?
No.
No, like.
But it's between 45 and 6. I can't tell y'all, it's like confidential. I could get my tongue ripped out.
Although Amy and her fellow Rushees are drained by the events of the first cut, the hard sell starts in earnest as the sororities and fraternities begin the second round, called Welcome Back Day.
All right, well, thanks, Steve. Guys, today what I want you guys to do while you're here, this is the day that you see through all the bullshit when you go to houses. See who's fucking lying to you, this is the day you tell who's full of shit and who's not. Leaders, guys. Athletes, leaders, plus pullers, all the important factors in college life. There's not just one general stereotype here, guys. Everyone's fucking cool guy, likes to hang out. That's why you guys are back here. Important thing when you go to these houses is feel where you fit in. This is how you make your decision. It's nothing else but the guys in the house.
For Welcome Back Day, Amy returned to 7 houses.
A-I-O is the only way to go. We are the best, forget the rest. We want you all to know that only A-L-P-H-A-C-H-I-O
is. We've had the first cut and now we're on our second round of parties. We had a great return rate, so that was wonderful. Our theme today is Summerfest at Alpha Chi. All of us are dressed up in bright colored dresses and we do a skit and we get to know the girls a lot better. It's a great day. A lot of times it's a real hard day for us because a lot of times it can be a real harsh cut, but it's going great. The girls are in high spirits and we're having a wonderful time.
On Welcome Back Day, the wooing process includes shows, sketches, and amateur dramatics, all of which is supposed to enhance the appeal of the different houses.
Welcome back to Pi Beta Phi.
Would you please come in?
You make me feel so good.
I don't think the way girls go through Rush is the best way for the incoming girls to pick the house, because they don't see a true depiction of what that house is like.
That was awesome. I think that's my favorite house so far. Yep. I think it's my favorite house so far. I like
really?
It
Why is
a lot. I knew an older sister in there of one of my guy friends who's awesome, and she is so nice, and all the girls in there that I talked to were like really like energetic, and like we didn't talk about like, what are you doing? What are you majoring in? Like you talk about in every house. I mean, sure, that comes up every once in a while. But now it's like, what we talked about, like movies and what's he talk about? Just a bunch of like crazy stuff, like Chicago, things like that. Things that, you know, we weren't talking about in other houses.
As Welcome Back Day draws to a close, the last batch of Pike House hopefuls make their way out. The house members waste no time deciding who will survive the second cut.
We had 21. 20 guys? And we bonked how many?
Six right now.
We kicked out six guys.
What was wrong with the six that you kicked out?
They just don't fit in. They're not like guys here.
How do you know they're not like you? I mean, what is it that...
You talk to them.
Personality.
You know. They'll ask you questions. They'll be like, you know, do you guys have tons of test files or do you guys study 9 hours a day? We'll be like, fuck no, we don't study 9 hours a day. Then we're like, thanks, we'll see you next year.
When I came through a lot of years ago, I only went through probably because my parents had never been Greek and my older brother was here. And he was in a fraternity, Sigma Chi, and so I had gotten to meet, he was 2 years older, so I had gotten to meet some of his lady friends, and they were Alpha Chi Omegas. And so, of course, I'd had that touch, so I thought, oh, they like me, I'll just, you know, I'll probably get in there, and that's what I really want to follow, because I had a familiarity with people. Well, they cut me, I think, the first or second round right away. And now, I joined Alpha Phi, and now I'm running the whole damn show, so I guess they've lost out.
The second cut has been unkind to Amy, and she has been rejected by all of her preferred choices.
I'm a little disappointed. I really wanted to go to Theta, and I really wanted to go to Pi Phi, and I had a lot of fun in those houses, and I think that the girls I really talked to, we generally, like, really connected and had a good time, and what was the other one? AD Pi, I really liked also, but in fact, I was surprised not to get invited back to that one, because all the girls who I had talked to the days before were like, you know, oh my God, we're so glad to have you back, and all this stuff. I mean, maybe that was another case of numbers or something like that, is that they'd rather take their chances on someone who's going to be a little more, I don't know, maybe go along with it a little more, maybe a little more of a follower to what they're going to do. Maybe they're afraid I'd, I don't know, rock the boat.
Despite the rejection, Amy is determined to persevere. RSVP Day gives her a chance to revisit four of her second choice houses. But while this year's Rushies are determined to break into their House of their Dreams, some older members are desperate to break out of their House of Horrors.
Usually what you do is you go to the house and talk to a group of girls and tell them why you're leaving and pretty much sign a form. But I really don't want to do that. I'm pretty much taking it into my own hands and I'm just writing them a letter about why I'm leaving and my reasonings for it. And I just think it would be better off for me this way and for them. I mean, if they have the letter, they can see that I'm going. So.
Christine Rooney has been a member of Alpha Chi Omega for 2 years. She felt ostracized by her fellow sisters and was told she didn't fit in. For several months now, she's been living outside the sorority house.
I didn't feel like the whole bonding experience. You know, it wasn't what I thought it would be, and I didn't think it was worth for me or my parents to spend the money on it, honestly, and I don't think. I mean, it was a hard decision for me to make because I put so much time into it. Like, I invested so much into it. I don't know if it was the house I was in or maybe just sororities weren't for me, just the whole general structure. And I think Rush started off because I hated Rush because I'm not a fake person. And they just kind of made you, like they molded you into some sort of image, which I guess I couldn't portray.
Who will fill our happiness, who and our togetherness, who and Alpha Chi is always true. Ooh, I want to linger, ooh, a little longer, ooh, a little longer with you. Ooh, this is the perfect night, ooh, and everything's just right, ooh, I want to stay a while with you. Ooh, so give a smile to me, ooh, I'll be a friend to thee, ooh, and I will give my heart to you. Ooh, we'll build our happiness, ooh, and our togetherness, ooh, and Alpha Chi is always true.
Now it's the end of the third round of parties, and we're going to have to go do more membership selection. It's the last cut that we get to make, so it's in a very important night. The girls are a little stressed out. It's the end of the week. That's pretty much it.
you do this whole thing in secret, don't you? Can you explain that to me?
Yes, we do. It's part of our ritual at Alpha Chi Omega that the way we select members is totally confidential, and it's not fair to us, or it's not fair to the girls who are going through Rush to divulge any of that information.
So what actually happens? Where do you go?
We'll be going downstairs into our dining room, and we're actually going to have dinner first, and then we'll get started.
And what happens is, how many people sit and talk and deliberate?
There's no deliberations at all. We just sit down there, and it's very quiet, and we go through the process of doing a membership selection.
And how do you do that? Can you explain what the mechanics of it are?
No, I can't. I can't do any of that. That's all confidential within Alpha Chi Omega.
The third cut is now underway, and it can be a brutal process.
People have been like, I don't want this girl in our house because this and this and this, and you get up and people yell at each other. And this girl's like, I think you're wrong because they're like, you're just being a bitch about that because I think you shouldn't judge a girl that way, and someone else would get up at this, and they'll go back and forth on it. So of course there is. I mean, again, like I said, you get a group of girls together. I think they have the one image they have up on top, and then they go down. It's so funny, like, you're in the house, so you're like, hi, how are you doing? Welcome to Alpha Chi. It was nice seeing you. You walk downstairs, they're like, oh.
Men's Rush finishes a day before the women's, and membership selection is brutal and honest.
Hey, shut up!
Did you meet him?
One of the times, you all right or no?
No one else talked to him.
Who talked to him? Bears, you say he's all right.
Yeah, Billy, we talked to him.
Billy?
He's all right.
Is he a Pike? Should we bring him back? That's all I want to know.
There's a nice guy over here. Right.
Fuck him? He's gone. Fine. Other houses don't do this, but what we do is if kids put us one and we like them, then we take them. If we're two or three, then we don't take them. Fuck them. We don't want them. If you didn't want us first, then we don't want you.
Good evening. This afternoon, in this room, from this chair, I testified before the Office of Independent Counsel and the grand jury. I answered their questions truthfully, including questions about my private life, questions no American citizen would ever want to answer.
She wants to everyone, how can we that navy blue dress is stained? Yeah.
I know that my public comments and my silence about this matter gave a false impression. I misled people, including even my wife. I deeply regret that. And so tonight, I ask you to turn away from the spectacle of the past 7 months, to repair the fabric of our national discourse, and to return our attention to all the challenges and all the promise of the next American century. Thank you for watching, and good night.
President Bill Clinton tonight admitting that he had a relationship with Monica Lewinsky.
I don't think he has good character, so that's why he should be out. Yeah, I don't think he's a good president.
You can't throw him out. He's still a man. Guys like that make mistakes.
I think girls were a little more shocked that it's true, where guys were like, yeah, I thought it was true the whole time, basically. Just because they know how he's probably thinking.
As the current president has been driven out of office, America's future leaders have been driven around unimpeded in their privately owned fire truck. The Pike House proudly display their 19 new members, who are determined to continue the Pike House traditions.
Getting photos here, and then we're going to go out to the res and party and fucking get hammered, then go out to the bars and get some chicks. We're going to get some chicks. Some tail.
Dude, chicks and parties tonight.
Dude, chicks parties, rock on.
Yeah, pretty much what's going on here.
For the women, the final tortuous round of interviews is still to come, and it is called Preference Night. where all Rushies must visit the three houses they have been invited back to. Amy has already decided which house she wants to join. It's a dangerous strategy.
Tonight I'll come back with these three houses on a sheet of paper, and you and I will sit down together, and we'll preference them. Not we, you will preference
them. Well, what if I only want one? Can I just put one down?
Okay, that's what's called suiciding, and we don't really encourage that. Okay, there's some kind of bylaw that states that if you should accept a bid, or if you go to preference parties, you cannot rush for another year, so one calendar year. So technically, if you choose to go to the preference party tonight, once you sign the preference card, you can't rush for another year.
That's fine. Okay. I mean, I'd rather...
Just as long as this isn't, like, a huge, like, loophole for you.
No, it isn't.
No. And, Amy, if you really want to, you know, if you want to do things like that, if that's, you know, I can't tell you not to do that. So you can put Simply Kappa down if that's what you want to do. Everything okay?
Uh-huh.
All right.
Okay.
All right, have a good day, Amy. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you. I gotta get my season tickets now.
So. All right. Bye-bye.
Okay. See you at 1. Okay.
I am a very stylish girl.
Preference night is the last hurdle for the sorority hopefuls. It is the last chance to select a sorority house, and everybody is dressed to impress.
How do I look?
Very good.
How do I look? How do I look? How do I look? Do I look?
Very good. I must say I'm amazed.
I am a very stylish girl.
Amy pursues her suicide bid for her preferred house. She has set her heart on getting into Kappa Kappa Gamma.
A very stylish girl.
But have they set their heart on her?
A very stylish
Amy
girl.
Amy Jones?
After this final encounter, Amy will have to wait until the following day to find out her fate. Preference night includes a secret ritualistic ceremony that is conducted in total secrecy.
It's a big deal. It's like the last night, and the girls here are the ones that they really could see fitting in the chapter. So it's a really serious night, and it's kind of emotional usually, mm-hmm. for all the chapters too.
It's something that's really special. I think you really feel the sisterhood in the house, and there's only certain times during the year that you really could say that you feel the sisterhood and it not feel stupid about it. It's really, we feel the bond and know why we're Alpha Chi's and why these girls should be Alpha Chi's too.
Tonight, our senior speaker, Jamie Valeri. Jamie is someone who's been very active in Alpha Chi, and we hope that the memories she has to share with you guys show how much Alpha Chi means to all of us.
Welcome again to Alpha Chi Preference Night. This night will be filled with such a variety of emotions for you that it may be overwhelming. I'm going to be leaving, but all my memories of living in the house, formals, this past summer, even this past week will be coming with me. And my photo albums, my mind, always my heart. Just as all of you Rushies are beginning a new journey, so too am I. You onto this incredible college dream world, and me onto the rest of my life. You always hear about people who could go back to their college days. Take advantage of it. Please, I beg of you, don't let it get away. Now I'm trying to slow my time down, but it's not really working. When I'm here at the house, I don't ever want to leave. And when I'm with the girls, I don't want them to ever go home. To all my friends that I can truly call my sisters, you have added so much to my life. So much I'm with. would have missed if I decided not to join Alpha Chi. Thank you for the incredible ride. Alpha Chi has brought us on a trip we'll never forget. Like I've always said, I've always wanted a sister, and now I have more than I can count. Thanks for everything, and I love you.
The Rushies are unaware that Jamie, for the third time tonight, has been moved to tears reading the same speech.
Thanks, Jamie. Please feel free to finish your dream.
Things soon cheer up, though, as the women are compensated with a slice of dream cake. The final night and the final serenade. For all the new Rushies, there is high expectation for their new tomorrow.
Really sweet, because some of the girls were crying, like the seniors, which is going to be their last rush, and they were saying like what their sorority meant to them and like how much it affected their lives and stuff, and so it was like really hard for them to say it. Like, and some of the other girls were crying too, because that was going to be the last time they were going to do it, not like out and out bawling, but just, you know, kind of sniffling or whatever. But I mean, it was nice, and it was pretty, and a lot of, they all sang and they have really good harmony. I can't carry a note if it was like handed to me on a tray, so I was like impressed by all that.
Don't come near me, I'm not the one to save your skin. But if the stars have brought you here, then here you are. Lock me into something new, something different from this. Is any blessing the solar system?
This is it! Last day. I'm over with. It's been a long week for all of them and me. We've got all the rush guests who they want, and we're going to read the chapters, and hopefully a lot of happy people. We try to make it move as quickly as possible because people are really tired. They can even do the simple tasks now, like alphabetizing last night. People didn't know their alphabet because we're tired. And there should be an excited, probably about 450 new women in our system, which is our leadership. So I'm exhausted. It is time to end this craziness.
Okay. First of all, you guys all did a very wonderful job. It's a long week, so thank you very, very much. Secondly, when you go to meet with your women, as soon as you're done meeting with them, you need to call in to check in with Tracy to say, all good to go, which means all your women's took their bids, they're happy, they're going to bid day. If a woman refuses to take her bid by signing that card last night, that means she cannot rush for a complete another year. She can't go rush until next fall.
Amy still doesn't know if her sorority bid has been successful. But Katie, the counselor, now knows the results.
I'm thrilled. I'm so excited. I think I have three girls that are going Kappa in my group, which is terrific for me. Are going Kappa, which is my sorority. Well, my real sorority. So I'm thrilled about it. It's really exciting. It's been really hard not to tell them all week, and now I get to. And yeah. And I'm actually, I mean, it's so exciting. I can't wait.
I'm waiting for Katie, my road guy. She's gonna bring me the envelope that says, like I put down on my preference card, my preferences, and she's gonna give me who I got. Dude, you like can't open it. It's locked.
Let me in. Go sit down. It's good. Look at the hair.
Look at the hair, dude. I'm Snoop. What's
hey,
up?
Kiddo.
I've got cornrows.
Tons of people in here. Okay. Voila, there's your bed.
Okay.
Go bonkers.
Now can I
rip it up and tear it open?
Well, I just painted my nails because I was bored because I wasn't allowed to leave my room.
Bye.
See?
Here.
Sweet as hell. I got the one I wanted.
You did?
Okay,
now,
yes.
Look at me, sweetheart.
Ah! She's one of my sorority.
It's been so fucking hard not to tell you all.
I was like, I like it. Look it. I don't want to get fingernail polish on it. Look it. See, look. There's my card. Oh God.
I am just so happy for you. I couldn't be happier. Congratulations.
Luckily with this recruitment, we had a wonderful recruitment, and we got quality and quantity, which is something that, you know, you can't always seem to find, and we were lucky enough to get it this year.
It's true that you do get something out of being in a sorority. Everything they say is not crap. The problem is it's so hard to discern between the chapters, and in the end, it probably really doesn't matter which one you choose.
Oh, the opportunities that it gives you is just incredible. The leadership opportunities, the way I have changed as a person and the leader that I have become because of this is something I would have never gotten anywhere else. It's not anything you can get, you know, that can be taught to you in school. It's, you know, it's these real life experiences where you have to be dealing with different kinds of people all the time and trying to figure out what is the best way to motivate 100 women. I mean, that's a challenge every day. I don't think it can be matched anywhere else.
Now that Amy has been recruited into the Greek system, the process of training her to become a fully fledged sorority girl begins. And over the next few months, the secrets of the house, known only to the Kappa Kappa Gamma members, will be revealed.
I mean, if you look around, I'm not your typical sorority girl, which is one of the reasons why I did it. You know, spice things up a little, you need to throw a little pepper in the mix. I thought it was more where I was going to be cutting people more than they were going to be cutting me, but, you know, that's the price for being a little more eccentric than others, I guess.
After an acrimonious confrontation, Christine Rooney was finally able to free herself from Alpha Chi Omega. Suzanne Berkman has been promoted to a senior position in the Greek Council. Tiffany is moving to Chicago to start work as a trainee tax consultant. After 6 months, Amy Jones left Kappa Kappa Gamma and the University of Iowa. She has no plans to return. And the Pikes continue their noble quest to collect used sorority underwear.
Come up.